Good morning, friends, and my dear children. Today we are going to learn about specific heat capacity. Okay, the next topic which is there in thermodynamics. Okay, so in previous video we have learned about different thermodynamical processes. Okay, so in this video we are going to learn about specific heat capacity. Okay, and we have learned that thermodynamics mainly deals with what? Heat exchange or energy exchange in the form of work. Okay, so in this video we are going to learn about specific heat capacity and molar specific heat capacity and certain relations. Okay, so let us start with the topic. Okay, so today's topic is about what? Specific heat capacity. Okay, specific heat capacity denoted by the letter small c. Okay, now it is denoted by the letter small c, right? C, I think you can able to see the board, small c, right? So this is a very important topic, and you are going to get certain new relations also in this topic. Okay, so specific heat capacity, what is meant by that? It is defined as the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance to 1 degree centigrade. Okay, what is the definition for this? The amount of heat required. Okay, now the amount of heat required to raise the temperature. To raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance. Okay, now to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance to 1 degree centigrade. You call this as what? Specific heat capacity. Okay, now, so C is defined as what? The amount of heat required. Heat, we will denote it with the letter Q. Okay, to raise the temperature of what? To raise the temperature for 1 gram of a substance. Okay, for unit mass of a substance. Okay, for unit mass of a substance, and that mass of the substance we call it as what? We'll denote it with small m. Here Q denotes the amount of heat, m denotes the unit mass of a substance. To 1 degree centigrade we have to increase the temperature, so there will be change in temperature, and that you are representing with what? Delta T. So C is equals to Q by m delta T. This is the formula for what? Specific heat. Okay, now specific heat capacity denoted by the letter small c. Okay, so this is the main formula which we have to learn about, right? So here we are learning about specific heat means already in a previous class we have learnt about different types of thermodynamical processes. Okay, once let us recall isothermal, adiabatic, like that we have learned certain isothermal certain thermodynamical processes. Okay, suppose if you go for isothermal process, in isothermal process, okay, now in isothermal process the specific heat capacity C, specific heat capacity C can be how much? Okay, now C is equal to how much? Okay, isothermal process means what? We have already learned the process which happens at constant temperature. Okay, now isothermal process means which happens at what? At constant temperature, isn't it or not? The process happens at constant temperature. Okay, if temperature is constant, then delta V becomes how much? Delta T becomes zero. That means there is no change in temperature. Then what about specific heat in isothermal process? Please understand the point carefully. Okay, then in place of delta T, you are keeping zero. So C is equals to Q by M into zero. Isn't it or not? So if it is M into 0, totally it is 0, so Q by 0, C is equals to q by 0, which is equal to what? Infinity. That means in isothermal process, specific heat value can be an infinite value also. Okay, now in isothermal process, specific heat value can be an infinite value. Okay, same like that if you go for adiabatic process. Okay, now in adiabatic process, okay, in adiabatic process, you remember that there is no exchange of heat. Okay, the system is totally what? Thermally isolated. That means no exchange of heat takes place. In what? Adiabatic process. So, in adiabatic process, okay, heat exchange is zero. That means Q is zero here. Okay, then what about this formula? Then specific heat capacity C becomes 0 by m delta T, which is equal to 0. That means what I mean to say is the specific heat value, the specific heat capacity value will range from 0 to infinity for different gases. Mostly we'll speak about what? The system will be mostly a gaseous system we'll take. Okay, then in such cases, the specific heat capacity runs from 0 to infinity. Isn't it or not? Its value ranges from what? 0 to infinity. Okay, so that is very, very important point. Okay, now please understand the point carefully. Right? 0 to infinity. So specific heat gases, this make it as a note point. Specific heat value of gases, okay, very, very important note point. If I write on the top, can you able to see? Okay, specific heat capacity for gases will be in between what? 0 to infinity. Okay, 0 to infinity. Okay, so please remember this point. Make it as a note point. Right? Make it as a note point. Very, very important. Right? So now we are going to learn about, I'm going to rub the board. You can able to copy it fast. Okay, so then we are going to learn about specific heat under two conditions. Okay, specific heat capacity under two conditions. What are those two conditions? One is at constant volume and one is at constant pressure. Okay, now specific heat capacity we have to learn under two conditions. Okay, now what are those two conditions? One is under constant volume and one is under constant pressure. Okay, so first one is at constant volume. Specific heat capacity at constant volume. Okay, now this we are going to denote it with letter CV. Please understand the notation, how you are going to represent. Okay, you're going to come across so many alphabets here. Okay, which alphabet belongs to what? That you have to be very careful with. Otherwise, you get confused. Okay, specific heat capacity at constant volume. You're denoting with letter what? CV. Okay, so CV is equals to what? Generally, C is equals to Q by M delta T. Isn't it or not? So CV is equal to what? Q by M delta T. Okay, Q by M delta T. This is at what? Constant volume. Okay, now this is at constant volume. Constant volume means what? Isochoric process. Okay, first I told you about isothermal process. In isothermal process, specific heat capacity we found it to be infinity. In adiabatic process, then we have moved on to adiabatic process. In adiabatic process, specific heat capacity is found to be zero. So specific heat capacity of gases will be in between what? Will be from zero to infinity. Isn't it or not? Now at constant volume means which process is this? This is isochoric process. So at constant volume Cv, we are denoting it with letter what? Cv. Okay, it is given by Q by M delta T. Okay, so if you go for the units for Cv, units for heat, Q units are what? Joules, and units for mass, automatically they are grams. And delta T means temperature only, no? Change in temperature or temperature, whatever it may be. If you speak about the units, they are same. So, units for temperature are what? Degrees centigrade. Okay, so units for specific heat capacity at constant volume. What are the units? Means what you will write? Joules per grams, degrees centigrade. Okay, now? Joules per grams, degrees centigrade. Okay, this is at what? Constant volume, Cv. Okay, similarly, if you go for specific heat capacity at constant pressure, okay, now at constant pressure, then you are going to denote it with letter Cp. Okay, now you are going to denote it with the letter Cp. So Cp is equal to how much? Q by M delta T. Here also Q by M delta T, but it is happening at what? At constant pressure. At constant pressure. Okay, constant pressure. That means which process is that? That will be isobaric process. Okay, now the process which happens at constant pressure, you call it as what? Isobaric process. So Cp is equals to Q by M delta T. Okay, then here also the units are found to be what? Okay, now units for Cp, if you go for. Here also Q units are what? Joules only. Joules by units of mass, grams only. And units of temperature, degrees centigrade. So Cp units are also joules by grams into degrees centigrade. Then units of both Cp as well as Cv, both are same. Isn't it or not? Both are same. But here, mainly in this chapter, we are very much concerned with specific heat capacities which are denoted by the letter Cp and Cv. Okay, but mainly we have to focus on not the normal specific heat capacities. We have to learn about molar specific heat capacities. This is the very important point which you need to remember. Okay, so we have to learn about what? Molar specific heat capacities. Okay, now what is molar specific heat capacity? Please, all of you have to be very conscious about here. From here, you have to be very conscious. Okay, up to now I have introduced a specific heat capacity. Now I'm going to introduce what? Molar specific heat capacity. Okay, now molar specific heat capacity. Okay, this is denoted also by the letter Cp and Cv only, but capital Cp and capital Cv. Okay, here also we can take at constant volume molar specific heat capacity. At constant volume, two specific heat capacities we are going to learn. Okay, one is at constant volume and another is at constant pressure. Okay, but here I am using the word molar. Okay, so molar heat capacity at constant volume, that means denoted by the letter capital Cv. Okay, small Cv is what? Only specific heat capacity. But capital Cv is what? Molar specific heat capacity. Okay, capital Cv. Then how to define this? Up to now, how we have defined this? The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a substance we have learnt. But if it is for molar specific heat capacity, okay, instead of using the word grams, we will use the word moles. Okay, so the amount of heat required, what is the definition for this? The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of what? Required to raise the temperature of one mole of a substance. Please remember this point. To raise the temperature of one mole of a substance. This is very, very important point. One mole of a substance, okay, to 1 degree centigrade is called as what? Molar specific heat capacity. Okay, now it is defined as what? The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of one mole of a substance. Okay, not 1 gram of a substance. That is very, very important point. One mole of a substance to 1 degree centigrade. You are denoting with the letter capital CV. Please remember. Okay, so CV. CV is equals to what? Q by M delta T. Up to now we have written. But here we are going to write what? N delta T. Okay, now Q by N delta T. Here N stands for what? One mole. Okay, now N stands for what? Number of moles. Okay, Q is as usual heat. Okay, now Q is the amount of heat required. Heat. Q stands for what? Heat. Here N stands for what? Number of moles. Instead of using the word grams, okay, we are using the word moles now. That's why molar specific heat capacity. Okay, and delta T as usual. Change in temperature. Okay, now change in temperature. In the same way, we can define even Cp also in the same way only. Okay, now Cp at constant pressure. Molar specific heat capacity at constant pressure. Molar. Please remember. Okay, second one is what? At constant pressure. The same thing. The amount of heat required to raise the temperature of one mole of a substance to 1 degree centigrade. You call it as what? Molar specific heat capacity. Okay, now. So Cp, capital Cp, is equal to what? Q by N delta T. Okay, now. Q by N delta T. So these formulas are very, very important formulas. Request all of you to please note down the formulas. And now we are going to learn about the relation between small Cp and capital Cp. Okay, let us keep the side heading for that. Please note down all these points. I'm going to rub the board, right? Yes. 1 second. Yes, I think you have noted. Right, now we are going to learn relation between small Cp and capital Cp, small Cv and capital Cv. Right, relation between small Cp and capital Cp. Similarly, small Cv and capital Cv. Relation between small Cv and capital Cv. Okay, what is the relation? Small Cv is for 1 gram. Okay, capital Cv is for 1 mole. Okay, then how can you define that? How can you relate both of them? Okay, how can we relate? We can relate them with the help of molecular weights, isn't it or not? Molecular masses. Okay, what is molecular mass of a gas denoted by the letter capital M? Isn't it or not? Suppose if you take, if you wanted to find the relation between these two, you can easily understand. Suppose small cv is specific heat capacity of oxygen gas, O2 gas. Okay. Then what is the molar specific heat capacity of same oxygen gas? Okay, anything they may give, H2N2, any gas they may give. Okay, then what is capital CV of O2 gas? Then what you will write? Okay, this is for 1 gram, small CV is for 1 gram of O2 gas. But 1 mole of O2 gas means capital CV is for what? 1 mole. Okay. 1 mole. Capital CV is for 1 mole. Please remember that point. Okay. Then for 1 mole of O2, how much it weighs? 1 mole of O2 gas weighs 32 grams. isn't it or not? 32. Oxygen molecular weight is how much? 32. Okay, na? Molecular weight of oxygen, 32. Okay, 1 mole of O2 is equal to 32 grams. Okay, so for 1 gram, for 1 gram of oxygen, specific heat is CV. Specific heat is small CV. For 32 grams of oxygen, specific heat will be how much? Specific heat will be 32 into CV. 32 into CV, small CV. So 32 into CV is equal to your capital CV. Isn't it or not? That means, what is the relation between small CV and capital CV? Just you need to multiply it with what? Its molecular mass. Isn't it or not? Therefore, okay, so capital CV is equals to molecular mass into small CV. Molecular mass into small CV. So MCV, capital CV is equals to capital M into small CV. Okay, so that is a relation. Capital CV is equals to M into small CV. This is the relation. Okay, similarly in terms of pressure also, you can write the same thing. Isn't it or not? In terms of pressure. Okay, relation between CP and CV. CP, capital CP and small CP. Okay, same like that. I'm writing directly. Similarly. Similarly, relation between CP and capital CP is what? Capital CP is equals to M into small CP. Okay, so that is only the relation. You have to multiply it with what? Molecular mass of that particular gas. Okay, so capital CP is equals to molecular mass of that gas into small CP. This is the relation. Okay, so you have to remember this relation. Very, very important. Please note down. Okay, so now we are going to, so these two are the important relations. Okay, important relations. CV is equals to MCV, CP is equals to MCP. Okay, so this is about molar specific heat capacities. Okay, molar specific heat capacities. Right, now we are going to introduce with a very, very important relation. Okay, very, very important. Okay, so very important relation between CP and CV. You keep 5 stars for this. Important relation between what? CP and important relation between CP and CV. Now we will not learn anything about small CP, small CV. Whatever CP, CV which we learn, that will be only about capital CP and capital CV only. Now, after introducing molar specific heat capacities, okay, we will speak only about molar specific heat capacities. We don't speak about normal specific heat capacities. So from now onwards, whatever the specific heats which I speak about, it will be about what? Molar specific heats only. Okay, so relation between capital CP and capital CV. Okay, capital CP and capital CV. Very, very important relation. And this relation, you call it as what? Mayer's relation. Mayer's relation. This relation is called what? Mayer's relation. What is the relation? CP minus CV is equals to R. What is CP? Molar specific heat capacity at constant pressure. What is CV? Molar specific heat capacity at constant volume. Okay, and what is R here? You have learnt R is what? Universal gas constant. Okay, now here R is universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. This is a very important relation which you need to remember for some time. How we get this relation? How we'll get R here? Okay, that can be understood only if you understand about first law of thermodynamics and only if you know about internal energy, okay, enthalpy, all those terms. After introducing those terms and after telling about first law of thermodynamics, then only we can derive this relation. So derivation part I'm not going to deal in this video, okay, but I'm introducing that relation, Cp minus Cv is equals to R. Please remember that relation. We have lot much to do with this relation. First of all, accept the formula. Okay, then how the formula comes, that we will be learning after introducing internal energy, enthalpy and first law of thermodynamics. After learning them, we can understand how can we derive this. That derivation part later we will learn. Okay, so Cp minus Cv is equals to what? Capital R. R is what? Universal gas constant. Okay, this important relation is called what? Mayer's relation. Okay, now Cp minus Cv is equals to what? R. Okay, right. Now, we have one more important relation between Cp and Cv with R. Okay, that also we will learn. Okay, so what is that? Here, we have one more thing to be introduced here. Okay, so Cv... One more important relation. Cv is equals to small f by 2 into R. This is one more formula. Okay. Ma'am, you are introducing new things. Yes. We will introduce new things and slowly you will learn all these terms very quickly and by practice it will become very easy for you. Okay. So capital Cv is equals to f by 2 into R. Okay. This is also one more important formula. Okay. Here, what is F? R means we are aware of that. It is universal gas constant. Then what is F here? Here, F is called as degree of freedom. Degree of freedom. Okay. F is called as what? Degree of freedom. What does that degree of freedom tells us for? Okay. That means all gases will not expand in the same manner. Isn't it or not? All gases will not expand in the same manner, even if you provide same conditions. So it depends on this F value. The expansion or compression of a gas depends on this F value. Okay. Okay. Even if you provide same external conditions like same pressure, same temperature, if you keep, all gases will not expand in the same manner. Okay. So that depends on one important factor, which is called as what? F. Okay. So F is called what? Degree of freedom. F is called what? Degree of freedom. Okay. So what does this degree of freedom will help you? This degree of freedom, okay, mainly depends on the atomicity of the gases. Very, very important points I'm telling. Please, without skipping the video, you should understand and you should learn. Okay. So please understand carefully. Okay, here F is what? Degree of freedom. Means which helps us to what extent the gas can be expanded or compressed. Okay, to say about that, F is useful. So then here F depends on what? This F value depends on, this F value depends on atomicity of the gases. Atomicity of the gases. Okay, now F value depends on what? The atomicity of gases. Okay, you have learnt monoatomic gases, diatomic, triatomic, like that. Okay, so F value depends on what? Atomicity of gases. So for monoatomic gases, okay, for monoatomic gases, F value is how much? 3. Please remember this. Monoatomic gases means what? Gases like inert gases. Okay. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. All these are what? Monoatomic gases. Okay. Monoatomic gases. Similarly, for diatomic gases. For diatomic gases, F value is 5. Okay, now. Please remember this value. What is F value stands for? Degree of freedom. What does it help for? It helps us to what extent, in what way a particular gas can be either expanded or compressed. ओके ना, एक्सपेंशन और कंप्रेशन इज टोटली डिपेंडिंग ऑन दिस एफ वैल्यू. ओके, दैट्स वाई वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट दिस एफ वैल्यू. सो फॉर डायटामिक गैसेस एफ वैल्यू इज हाउ मच? 5. वॉट आर डायटामिक गैसेस? गैसेस लाइक ओ टू, एटॉमिसिटी 2, ओ टू, एच टू, एन टू. ओके, फॉर ऑल दोज गैसेस, डायटामिक गैसेस, एफ वैल्यू इज हाउ मच? 5. प्लीज रिमेंबर दीज वैल्यूज. ओके ना, फर्स्ट एक्सेप्ट द वैल्यूज, देन हाउ ऑटोमेटिकली यू विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दीज ऑल वैल्यूज केम. एक्सपेरिमेंटल वैल्यूज दीज आर, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दीज वैल्यूज, राइट? सो फॉर ट्राईटामिक गैसेस, ओके ना, फॉर ट्राईटामिक और बेटर आई से पॉलीएटॉमिक, फॉर पॉलीएटॉमिक गैसेस, ओके, फॉर पॉलीएटॉमिक गैसेस एफ वैल्यू इज 6. ओके ना, फॉर पॉलीएटॉमिक गैसेस एफ वैल्यू इज हाउ मच? 6. दीज थ्री वैल्यूज प्लीज रिमेंबर. ओके ना, प्लीज रिमेंबर दीज थ्री वैल्यूज, एफ वैल्यू एंड सी वी इज इक्वल्स टू एफ बाई टू आर. ओके, नाउ इफ यू आर गोइंग टू सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस एफ बाई टू आर वैल्यू इन द मेयर्स रिलेशन, वॉट इज मेयर्स रिलेशन? मेयर्स रिलेशन, वॉट इज मेयर्स रिलेशन? सी पी माइनस सी वी इज इक्वल्स टू आर आई सेट. बट इन प्लेस ऑफ आर, इफ आई कीप एफ बाई टू आर, ओके, देन वॉट इज सी पी वैल्यू? सी पी इज इक्वल्स टू, इन प्लेस ऑफ सी वी आई एम कीपिंग एफ बाई टू आर इज ईक्वल टू आर. ओके, वंस अगेन आई विल रब एंड राइट, आई एम रबिंग दिस एफ वैल्यू. ओके, प्लीज रिमेंबर 3, 5, 6 फॉर मोनो डाई एंड ट्राई एटॉमिक गैसेस द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ इज हाउ मच? 3, 5, 6 रेस्पेक्टिवली. ओके, सी हियर वी नो सी पी माइनस सी वी इज ईक्वल्स टू आर, दिस इज वन रिलेशन विच वी नो. And I told you one more relation to remember. Okay, so Cp minus, in place of Cv, I am writing what? F by 2 into R is equal to R. This F by 2 R, I am taking that side. Then Cp value, how much you will get? R plus F by 2 into R. That means R, if you take common, 1 plus F by 2. 1 plus F by 2. So Cp value is how much? R into 1 plus F by 2. Okay, now R into 1 plus F by 2. So, this is also one more important relation which you need to remember. Okay, so CV value F by 2 R, CP value 1 plus F by 2 into R. Okay, and now I'm going to introduce to you one more important relation. Okay, please. The video will become a little bit longer, but without skipping the video, please keep write and practice. Okay, please write and practice. Yes, I'm rubbing this. So CV is equals to F by 2 R, CP is equals to 1 plus F by 2 into R. Okay, two relations we got here. Right? Fine. Now I'm going to introduce one more ratio. The ratio between CP and CV. They'll be asking questions about these only. Okay, based on these. Ratio. Ratio of CP and CV. Capital CP and capital CV. Please remember. Ratio. Okay, CP by CV is equals to. This ratio is called as what? Gamma. CP by CV is denoted by the letter what? Gamma. This ratio is called as what? Poisson's ratio. Please remember this ratio also. Poisson's ratio. Cp by Cv is equals to what? Gamma. Okay. Cp by Cv. The ratio of Cp and Cv. Molar specific heat capacity at constant pressure by molar specific heat capacity at constant volume. This ratio is given by the formula gamma. Okay, na, gamma. Gamma is equals to Cp by C. Okay, so if you calculate for all the three types of gases, if you calculate this ratio for three types of gases, for monoatomic, for diatomic and for triatomic gases, this calculation of gamma we will do. Okay, na, calculation of gamma for mono, tri, diatomic gases. Okay, calculation of gamma. Calculation of gamma value. Okay, for first one, for monoatomic gases. For monoatomic gases. Okay, now what is this ratio? For monoatomic gases, what is the ratio for Cp by Cv? Okay, what we have learnt? Cv is equals to F by 2R and Cp is equals to F by 2 plus 1 into R. Cp by Cv we have to do now. Okay, and in place of F, we will substitute the value 3 for monoatomic gases. For monoatomic gases, I am taking the ratio of these two values. Okay, so Cp by Cv I have to do. Cp by Cv is equals to F by 2 plus 1 into R by Cv means F by 2R. Cv means F by 2R. Here RR gets cancelled. Okay, so I am taking the ratio here. So F plus 2 by 2 by F by 2. Isn't it or not? So cancel this 2 2. F by F plus 2 by F. Okay, so what is F value? F value you all know for monoatomic gases it is? For monoatomic gases it is 3. Okay, so substitute for monoatomic gases. For monoatomic gases, F is how much? 3. Okay, now for monoatomic gases, F is 3. So, substitute F by 2 plus F is equal to 3 plus 2 by 3. 3 plus 2 is how much? 5. 5 by 3. Okay, for monoatomic gases, Cp by Cv ratio is how much? 5 by 3. Okay, now for monoatomic gases, Cp by Cv ratio is how much? 5 by 3. I think you can able to understand what I am telling. Okay, for monoatomic gases, Cp by Cv ratio how much? 5 by 3. Cp by Cv. How much we are getting here? F plus 2 by F we are getting. Okay, by calculating this, Cp by Cv is how much we are getting? F plus 2 by F. Okay, for monoatomic gases, F is how much? 3. F is 3. So, substitute 3 there. Okay, how much you are getting? 5 by 3. Okay, 3 plus 2 by 3, which is equals to 5 by 3. Okay, this is for monoatomic. Now for diatomic gases, F value how much? F is 5. Okay, for diatomic gases, F value is 5. So substitute in place of F, you keep 5. Okay, in place of F, keep 5. How much you are getting? 5 plus Cp by Cv is equal to, for diatomic gases, 5 plus 2 by 5. How much? 7 by 5. Similarly, for triatomic or for polyatomic, F value how much I said? 6. F is 6. So, Cp by Cv will be how much? 6 plus 2 by 5, which is equal to what? 8 by 5. Okay, 8 by 5. So like that, if you calculate all these values, okay, for monoatomic gases, for triatomic gases and for polyatomic gases, okay, you have to calculate these values. And if you just take ratio of these three, okay, if you take ratio of these three, 5 by 3 will be almost equal to how much? 1.66. 5 by 3 will be almost equal to 1.66 and 7 by 5 will be almost equal to 1.4. Okay, now 1.4 and 8 by 5 is almost equal to 1.33. Okay, so what I am going to tell you is ratio of these three. Okay, now gamma value for mono, di and triatomic values. Okay, gamma for mono is 2. Gamma for diatomic gases is 2. Gamma for tri or polyatomic gases. This ratio is always fixed ratio. 1.66 is 2. 1.4 is 2. 1.33. This is fixed. Okay. So this value very very important, and you will be getting these questions for doing numericals. Okay. So this is what we call it as molar specific heat capacity values. Okay. So I'm stopping the video up to here. Okay. You please keep pause the video and please note down and make a notes and then practice. Okay. Until then, keep learning, happy learning, all the best. Your hard work is your superpower. Thanks for watching. Bye.